Hello guys, and welcome to this very short and basic tutorial of how to use the heads-up display on a Boeing 737-800 for an ILS approach. The heads-up guidance system calculates and displays the information required on the heads-up display which you see in front of you. The mode which the aircraft is currently on is the A3 approach mode, which is designed for precision manual ILS approach and landing operations down to Cat 3 minimums. This allows pilots to land the aircraft accurately and reliably in IMC and very low visibility conditions. Now we will learn how to use the information displayed to monitor and land the aircraft safely. As you can see, we are on final approach, runway 04 left and perfectly aligned. Now pause. So in this mode, there is no speed or altitude tapes as they were all decluttered to save space and make it easier for the pilot to have a visual outside the aircraft while having the information he needs. At the top, we have a bank indicator with the heading under it. To its left, it shows MCP speed, which means auto throttle is active and the airspeed set on the autopilot is 132 knots. Next to the MCP, we have VOR lock, which means that we are tracking the localizer. To the right, it shows flare, which means flare mode is armed, where it kicks in about 50 feet above the runway. This weird semicircle is the angle of attack of the plane, which means the angle between the wings and the relative wind. The slight extension above it indicates the normal angle of attack during the ILS approach. This is the aircraft symbol, commonly referred to as the bore sight symbol, represents the projected center line of the aircraft. It is positioned at a fixed position on the display, unlike all the other symbols which are placed around it. This long horizontal line is the local horizontal plane. It is displayed relative to the aircraft reference symbol. The distance between them is equal to the pitch angle, so as you can see here, we are definitely pitched up to make it easier to flare on short final. The pitch state scale is fixed to the horizon line. It is usually scaled to in 5-degree increments. This dotted line indicates our glide slope of minus 3 degrees, and the arrow perpendicular to it is the localizer for the runway. At the intersection is our flight path vector, which shows where the aircraft is actually going. It is the sum of all the forces acting on the aircraft. So, as you can see here, though we are pitched up above the horizon, indicated from the aircraft reference line, we are losing energy and descending, so the aircraft is really moving downwards. The flight guidance systems can also provide visual cues, which is this small circle which fits inside the flight path vector symbol. Pilots can fly along the correct flight path by flying to the guidance cue. This mark is the acceleration indicator or energy cue. It is above the flight path vector if the aircraft is accelerating, and below the flight path vector if it is decelerating. Here it is in the middle, which means we have a stable speed. This is our actual airspeed, and not the one set on our autopilot. Here it is the same. This is the radio altimeter, which tells us our altitude above the ground level, while this is the barometric altitude above sea level and descending at a vertical speed of 700 feet per minute. Finally, this is our speed above the ground, determined by tail or headwinds. We are 4 nautical miles out on the ILS approach. Now, let's continue. Unpause. So as we are approaching the runway, you'll notice some neat changes to our display. Any new information or changes that are required for the pilot to use on short final will appear, and any unnecessary information will just go away. This is essential for the pilot to provide optimum conditions. At 300 feet above ground level, runway edge lights will appear, telling the pilot where to look for the runway in low visibility. Nice, huh? This is of great help if the runway is not visible until touchdown, and will help expect where the runway location is. Now watch closely as we approach 300 feet for the runway edge lights. Here they are slightly off to the left, but that's okay, it depends on your scenery and it will deviate based on that. At 100 feet above the runway, the ground is getting closer and will pass through our flight path vector at 50 feet and the aircraft will start flaring. Now it's time to retard the throttles, wait for touchdown, announce speed brakes, and activate reverse thrust. Thrust idle at 80 knots, start manual braking, and exit the runway when able. Now on the ground, all the useless information disappears to provide you with a better view. This is just amazing technology which was implemented on a Boeing 737-300 in 1995 and continues today. Now, you have a basic knowledge of the heads-up display and how to use it in just under 5 minutes. I do not want to get too detailed in this guide, or else it would be a much longer video. If you'd like more tutorials like this, please keep me notified in the comments. Now I'm going to leave you with a final approach again to marvel at this technology. Please rate and subscribe to stay tuned, and thank you for watching.
Fifty, forty, thirty, twenty, ten. 40, 30, 20, 10.